Dear children, let us welcome to the Geography second chapter, Physical Features of India. After studying a brief history of formation of India and its some of the new main features, let us start with the actual topic of the chapter. In India, we are having six types of major physiographic divisions. Out of them, the very first one, Himalayan mountains. The complete north, northeastern and northwest. Likewise, an arc-shaped Himalayan ranges, they are present towards the north of India. The second part or the second division is the northern plains, which is below at the foothills of Himalayas. The third major division is the peninsular plateau, that is the central India. The fourth division is the Great Indian Deserts, also known as the Thar Deserts. The fifth division or the fifth physiographic division is the coastal plains. As India is having such a vast coastline, we are having an important economically, culturally and politically also the western coastal plains and the eastern coastal plains. And the last physiographic division, we are having the island groups. In Arabian Sea, Lakshadweep Islands, and in Bay of Bengal, we have a group of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now, when we will study all these physiographic divisions, in detail, we will see their features. How have they formed? What is their importance? What is the main feature of that? What are the important places in them? Likewise, let us start studying each physiographic division of India in detail. On the map, these divisions are shown. This is your textbook map. So here we have a dark shaded region. This is Himalayan mountain ranges. All these ranges which I am circling, they have been formed at the time of the formation of Himalaya, that means at the time of the collision of Indo-Australian plate and Eurasian plate. We have a second division, that is the northern plain. Now this is a light shaded region, northern plains we have. After that we have the deserts. These are the parts of the deserts. Followed by that, we are having a major section which is slightly dark in color. This is a plateau region, peninsular plateau region. Along with that, we are having, if you will see clearly, the western ghats are marked and even eastern ghats are marked. Now near to that, we have a narrow coastal line, and these both the coastal lines, they are important. If you will see coastal line only, we are having the Tamil Nadu region, Andhra Pradesh region, along with that the Orissa parts are there. We have our complete Maharashtra western coastal region where Mumbai, Goa, all these places are there. Along with that, Kerala is also a part of that. So this coastal plains are important to study. We have after that the two group of islands, Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep. So likewise, let us study each one of them in detail. Let us begin with the first physiographic division, Himalayan mountains. Himalayas, the name itself in Sanskrit, as we call the house of snow, fully covered with snow, as it is the loftiest mountain. As we are aware, Mount Everest, the world's highest peak, is there in these mountains. Hence, these are the world's highest mountains. And as the altitude increases, the temperature decreases and the regions are very cold. Himalayas as shown in the map. Now, as Himalayas, you will see over here, they have shaded the region dark. That means this is an elevated part. Along with that, they have made these lines. Now, these lines, they show that these are the ranges, various ranges. Ranges, group of hills or group of mountains actually. Himalayas are made up of various ranges. The main Himalayas, they are having three ranges which we will be studying in detail. and the remaining part, they are of course the Trans-Himalayas also they are called as. So in the Trans-Himalayas we generally get the Jaskar range, the Ladakh range, the Karakoram ranges. These are also of course the part of Himalayas, but basically the major three ranges are different. And those three ranges which we will be studying now, they are starting from the Great Himalayas, that is this one which you will see most continuously going on. This is the first range. After that you are having the second range, which is a broken range. We have the last range, that is the Shivaliks. So likewise we will be studying Himalayas three ranges. The first one you have Himadri, you have second Himachal, and the third range Shivaliks. So let us begin with the Himalayas in general description. Now in general we will see Himalayas are geologically young. As I told you that the complete earth is made in various geological phases. That means the history of formation of earth, we had various geological phases, ages were there. In that, the recent action was the formation of Himalayas. So Himalayas are recently formed in the geological history. For us it is a very long history or many years, but then geologically that was the major change which has occurred. So geologically these mountains are young. Structurally these mountains are fold mountains. As we have studied that Indo-Australian plate, it started drifting towards the Eurasian plate. In between there was a geosyncline which was Tethys Sea. Now when the Indo-Australian plate, it has pushed or pressed completely the Tethys Sea, the sediment inside them, it has raised high. And as a result, at the joining part of Indo-Australian plate and the Eurasian plate, we have the formation of the Himalayas. So Himalayas are basically located on the plate margins or the plate boundary. And these plates are still moving, as we are aware, due to the convectional currents. So Himalayas are still showing some kind of improvement or some kind of increase in its height. And hence in that region we still experience earthquakes and all. We have the third characteristics of Himalayas. They run from west to east direction. So yes, they are covering the complete northern India. So some parts of northwest, that is from Indus River it starts, and then it goes covering maximum part of the northern India, and then it goes till river Brahmaputra. So Indus, as it is located in our west, whereas Brahmaputra is located on the east. So from Indus River fault, that means a gap, till the Brahmaputra River fault, that means a gap, Himalayas are spread. Next characteristics, they are the loftiest mountain. These are the highest. Loftiest, it means highest mountains. Most rugged mountain barrier. It is actually not a very smooth or very clear mountain basically. It's very difficult to climb and cross. Rugged, that means very rough topography. It is having a shape of an arc. It is not straight, northwest, north and northeast. Likewise, it is an arc shaped mountain. The total distance of Himalayas 2400 km. Very long it is. And the width, talking about the width, there are many variations. 400 km it is in Kashmir. So in Kashmir region it is very broad, as in the map also we can see. Whereas as it goes towards the eastern side or northeast side, it becomes narrow. So there it ranges 150 km. Altitudinal variations. Altitudinal variations, that means similar heights or the variations. There are lots of variation in the eastern side. Eastern side, that means Arunachal Pradesh side, it is having most of the variations. Lots of ups and downs are there. Whereas these variations we do not find in the western half. western half, Jammu Kashmir and all, more or less the heights are same. After this, the major characteristics, the Himalayas region range wise, they are divided into three major ranges: Himadri, Himachal, Shivaliks. So the northernmost range is Himadri, the central range is Himachal, and the southernmost range, which is touching to our northern plain, that is Shivaliks. These three ranges, they also differ in the height. Himadri, it is very much heighted. It is this range only in which Mount Everest and all is there. We are having second range, Himachal, that is height wise, that is lesser than the Himadri, and Shivaliks, less height, the height goes on decreasing. So till here it was general features of the Himalayas in total. So now let us study the range wise division of Himalayas. This range wise division of Himalayas is also called as longitudinal division. That is from north to south division, hence it is a longitudinal division. North to south, it is northern side is Himadri, Himachal, and southern side we have the Shivaliks. So that's why it is a longitudinal north-south division or range-wise division. So if it is asked any of these, we have to give the description of these three ranges. Let us begin with the first range, Himadri. Himadri ranges, they are also called as Greater Himalayas or Inner Himalayas. They are inside, very much inside. That means when the plates were getting folded, at that time these Himalayas were found in the central region. So they are very elevated, of course. So this is the three name. These are the three names which we call to this particular range, Himadri range. Now this range is the most continuous range. We don't have any breakage or passes in them. We don't have many passes. Passes, that means the gaps in the mountain range. We don't have the passes in this. Very hardly few are only there, and that too very difficult to cross. So it is the most continuous range. It is famous for the loftiest peaks. The list of the peaks is given in your textbook. You will be going through them. And one of the loftiest peak, as we are all aware, as shown over here, the Mount Everest. The average height, now average height, we are not talking about the Mount Everest height. Here the average height of Himadri is 6000 meters from the sea level. It is containing all the prominent Himalayan peaks. The mountain is made up of fold mountain, and the folds are asymmetrical. Now what is asymmetrical? Asymmetrical, if I want to make a triangle or a hill, I can draw perfect symmetry over here. That means equal on both the sides. But such kind of symmetry we do not find in any of the peak or any of the hills of Himalayas. You will see over here, not a single hill is complete. They are all overlapping. So they are asymmetrical. One side we can draw, but another side it is half. So these are all asymmetrical ranges. These are perennially snowbound. Himadri throughout the year is covered with snow. It is never actually without snow. As a result, most of the glaciers descends from the here, right? So most of the glaciers are descending from these ranges. World's highest peak, Mount Everest, is located in this particular range. So these things we have to learn. That's why I have specifically made a separate display of this. The world's highest peak is Mount Everest, 8848 meters. Highest peak of Himalayas in India. As we are aware, Mount Everest, even though highest, but it is not in India, it is in Nepal. So then which is the highest peak of Himalayas in India? So that is Kanchenjunga. The height is 8598 meters. Which is the highest peak of India then? So Himalayan highest peak in India is Kanchenjunga. But what is the highest peak of India? So that is K2, and K2 is located in the Karakoram ranges. That is 8611 meters. So these three things you should prominently remember. World's highest peak is Mount Everest. India's highest peak is K2. Whereas India's Himalayan highest peak is Kanchenjunga. Clear. Moving to the second range, Himachal. This is a central range. They are also called as Lesser Himalayas. Lesser, they are less in height from the Himadri and even the other mountains above. Now, which range is this? This is the range which is lying south to the Himadri. This is also the most rugged mountain system. It is not at all actually clear. It is not at all symmetrical. As you can see at the back of the picture, there is no symmetry in these mountains. Very rough mountains these are. This is the discontinuous range. Discontinuous range, like you have mountain ranges like this and then breakage and breakage and breakage, like means there are many passes in this particular range. There are many gaps actually. So many gaps are there, mountain gaps are there. So this range is especially made up of only variety of ranges. Now the part, this particular range is made up of which type of rock? This is made up of highly compressed and altered rock. Compressed and altered rock, it means like when the plates might have dashed each other, it is basically a sediment, that means a sedimentary rock. And inside the lava must have also combined in them. But then it has totally changed, as we have studied the metamorphic rock. Metamorphic, it means when the basic rock will change into a totally different rock. So this is metamorphic rock, altered rock, changed rock, and highly compressed rock this is. Altitude, the average altitude is varying between 3700 meters to 4500 meters. As for Himadri, it was 6000. Here it is varying. And width here is 50 kilometers. So this is 50 kilometer wide. That is much larger actually. Now this range is famous for what? This range is famous for various ranges actually. There are many ranges which are famous. And out of which the Pir Panjal range is the longest range and the most important also. Other than Pir Panjal range, we are having Dholadhar range, Mahabharat range, likewise many ranges are there. This range is also famous for valleys, Kashmir Valley, Kangra Valley, Kulu Valley. Kulu Valley, valleys, it means when the river is flowing through the mountains in between. So these valleys, they create beautiful scenery, tourist locations. So this is why the range is famous for that. Because what happens in Himadri, there are glaciers and these are all snow covered. So we don't have the beautiful fast flowing rivers in Himadri mainly. Himadri, the rivers are originating. But by the time they come to Himachal, they are converted into a river form and they have eroded many places, and that's why they are having number of valleys here in Himachal Pradesh. And these Himachal Pradesh, and not only that, in Himachal ranges we have many beautiful scenic beauty, or the hill stations are there. So this range is also known for the hill stations. Few names of the hill stations, they have been listed in the book. You will go through them, like Nainital, Mussoorie. Likewise, we have many. Moving to the next range, the third range. This is the outermost range. If you remember, Himadri we called innermost range. Whereas Shivaliks, this is the southernmost or outermost range. Width of here, Himalayas are 10 to 50 kilometer. Altitude is also very less. You will find it is 900 to 1100 meters only. So we started with 6000 meters, moved to the 4500 meters, and now to the lesser height we are coming down to 900 to 1100 meters. Now this particular range is made up of unconsolidated sediments brought down by the rivers. This is important. Now till the rivers they reach to shivaliks, they might have eroded or they erode lots of sediment basically. And this sediment, because the height is reducing, the speed of the river is also reducing. And as the speed will reduce, what will happen? The river will start depositing the sediment. And most of the deposition of the sediment is done here in the Shivaliks range. Now the word unconsolidated. Consolidated, it means solidified, very tight, very strong. But this is unconsolidated, this is loose because constantly the rivers are depositing. So then what happens? The river, because the rivers are constantly bringing the sediment and the range is made up of unconsolidated material, this range is very much prone to the landslides, covered with thick gravel and alluvium. These are all the types of sediment which are loose. So very quickly this range is prone to the landslides because the land is not very strong if it is not under the vegetation cover. So Shivaliks are having the danger of landslides. With Shivaliks we are having one famous thing. As every range is famous for different things. Like Himadri, they were famous for highest peaks. The Himachal, famous for valleys and hill stations. And Shivaliks, they are famous for, we write over here the word dunes. Now dunes, like you might have heard, Dehradun. Now what is dune basically? So dune, it means the ranges here which I am marking, let us consider them as Himachal. They are written also Lesser Himalaya. This is Himachal range and we have another range. This is Shivaliks range. You will find that between Himachal and Shivaliks we have a valley. These valleys are there. These regions, the empty region, or this is a U-shape, like an armchair type of places. These are called as dunes. If you remember, like dunes, Dehradun is also one of them. These places are used for agriculture, they are used for ship rearing, likewise. So these places are famous in Shivaliks as they go and merge with the Shivaliks. Now till now we have done the range wise division. Range wise, that means we have done the north to south, northernmost Himadri and then till southern Shivaliks. So this way we have done the division, longitudinal division. Now we will be doing the region wise division. Now region wise division, I'll just show you first that how does it go. Region wise division, this is how the picture, and we will see what are those regional divisions. Like Himalayas, as we said, they are covering the complete north to northwest. That means north, full side of north, and then north and northeast. Likewise, this is an arc shape actually. Now in this region wise division, it means from west to east. This is also called as west to east division also. West to east division, it means this section, what it is known by, another section, and likewise we are having four sections. So it is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So north to south we were having three divisions, here we are having four divisions. As it is shown over here, four divisions are there. So the first section, this is a section, the another one, this is one, the third one, the part is here, and this is like here. If you will see the Himalayas which are present here, first division. The second division is here. The third division, which is covering full Nepal, and fourth division is covering this last section. Now how have we made these divisions? We have made these divisions with the help of rivers. So we have the presence of one river over here and another river over here. So this section we gave one name. Then another, this river and the next river, we made the second division. Then this river and the next river, we made the third division. and then from here to here we made the fourth division. So likewise we are having four divisions of Himalayas. Now let's go back. This is the one. Here we have those rivers. The first part starts from river Indus to river Satluj, and this section of Himalayas, it has various names. It is called as Punjab Himalaya, Kashmir Himalaya and Himachal Himalayas because it is covering all the three states. We have the second river set from river Satluj to river Kali. These sections are called as Kumaon Himalayas, generally covering Uttarakhand. We have the third section, river Kali to river Tista. This is fully the Nepal Himalayas. And then last, the river Tista to river Dihang. This is Assam Himalaya, that is covering the northern part of the Assam Arunachal Pradesh regions. So this is called as the region wise division, or it is also called as the east to west division or west to east division. Anyways, you should not be confused in the regional division and range wise division. North to south division is different, east to west divisions are different. And these rivers have to be learned thoroughly. You have to learn it thoroughly. Indus to Satluj, Satluj to Kali, Kali to Tista and Tista to Dihang. Without seeing, you will be attempting this question. So this is the regional division of Himalayas. Now in the regional division of Himalayas, we have done till here. If you will see, river Brahmaputra is given, right? So till river Brahmaputra we have done. So it means Himalayas we have studied mainly till here. But then some Himalayan ranges or some hilly region we are also find over here, this small section which goes down also. It goes till down. So this is the Himalayas eastern section. This is called as Purvachal. Now Purvachal is mainly covering the Nagaland, Mizoram, Tripura, likewise these regions. And these Himalayas, these are also the part of Himalayas. This is a separate part of that. So from here I will like to take your attention towards this. We have, of course, this is a river Tsangpo which is coming from the China. This is none other than the Brahmaputra river. Now here you are having one important peak, Namcha Barwa. Our Tsangpo river takes a U-turn and then it enters and Brahmaputra starts. So it means the part of Himalayas, these parts and these parts are divided. Hence we study the Purvachal Himalayas separately. Now let us study about the Purvachal Himalayas. What are these Purvachal? Beyond Dihang Gorge. Now Dihang is nothing but, I'll take your attention again here. Dihang is nothing but the river Brahmaputra. When the river Brahmaputra enters into Arunachal Pradesh, it gets the name Dihang. So in China it is known as Tsangpo. When it is entering into Arunachal Pradesh, it is called as Dihang. And when it goes in Assam, it is known as Brahmaputra. It is just the same river actually. So hence they call it as Dihang Gorge. Now gorge, a valley basically. River is making a valley, deep valley, because these are all upper Himalayas. So their deep valleys are made by rivers. And through this valley or through this gorge, Himalayas, they bend sharply down. It means they move down and to the south, and then they spread along the eastern boundary. And in India, this eastern boundary Himalayas are called as Purvachal. Now gorge, I would like to take your attention. Gorge, it means when a river makes a valley, a deep valley, very deep and eye-shaped valley, narrow valley due to the erosion, right? Due to the erosion. Sometimes the valleys are also made due to the faults also. Fault like when the plates will move away from each other, like you have studied ridges and all. But here that is not the case. The river has eroded that part and hence the valley has been made. Now what are the characteristics of Purvachal? Purvachal, it is running through northeastern states. Northeastern states, Mizoram, Nagaland, likewise. It is composed of strong sandstones. It is not like unconsolidated. It is very strongly built of sandstones, and sandstone is a sedimentary rock. It is covered with dense forest. They all run as the parallel ranges. They are not very zigzag, they are parallel. And these are the hilly hills they are calling, but group of hills. It covers Naga Hills, Manipur Hills, Mizo Hills, Patkaibam Hills. So these are the main hilly regions which are covered in the Purvachal. So this is what was regarding in total the Himalayas. I'll give you the assignment work, what you have to do. The features and everything has to be learned thoroughly. Thank you.